never know. उन्हें ठीक है माउस को मत हिलाना, इससे नीचे करना है ठीक है. कर दो स्टार्ट.
गुड आफ्टरनून, दिस इज जेवी एंड डॉक्टर लिली त्रिवेदी गिविंग अ लेक्चर इन MSc बॉटनी थर्ड सेम. कोर्स नेम प्लांट पैथोलॉजी एंड प्लांट प्रोटेक्शन एंड द मॉड्यूल नेम इज हिस्टोरिकल एंड डेवलपमेंटल एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ प्लांट पैथोलॉजी. इंट्रोडक्शन. इट वॉज थियोफेस्ट्रेस इन 370 एंड 286 BC. He was a Greek philosopher who first talked about plant disease. He wrote a book entitled Inquiry into Plants, and he wrote the observations regarding diseases in this book. Historically, plant pathology in India is quite ancient and nearly 4000 years old. There are references to plant diseases and their control in Rig Veda, Athar Veda, Arth Shastra of Kautilya, Sushastra Samhita, Agni Purana, the holy book written in India. However, Vraksh Ayurveda book written by Surapala in ancient India is probably the first treatise in which he gave detailed account on plant disease and their control. The discovery of microscope by Anton von Leeuwenhoek. He discovered his own microscope in 1675. He first saw the microbe, that is bacteria, and discovered the microbial world. The microbial world was Noll and Ruska discovered electron microscope in 1932. The beginning of modern plant pathology. In 1845, a mysterious and terrible potato murine appeared in the Western Europe. This potato murine destroyed the Irish potato crop to the extent that 1 million people died of starvation and malnutrition, and similar number of people immigrated from Ireland to United States. It was Heinrich Anton de Bary who finally proved experimentally in 1857 that the causal agent of late blight of potato has been a fungus, namely Phytophthora infestans. Anton de Bary from 1831 to 1888 was considered as father of experimental or modern plant pathology. He also discovered heterotrichum in uridinales and the nature of obligate and facultative forms of life. The phytopathogenic nature of bacteria. T.J. Burrell of the University of Illinois, USA was the first time in 1878 showed that firebright of disease of pear and apple is caused by bacterium. Now it is known as Irvinia amylivora. In fact, it was the discovery of phytopathogenic nature of bacteria by T.J. Burrell. E.F. Smith is considered the father of phytobacteriology for his discoveries and methodologies. He introduced for the study of bacterial disease during 1905 and 1920. So the father of phytobacteriology is E.F. Smith. Then we have another discovery which is important, that is Koch postulates. Robert Koch is known as father of microbial techniques. He first laid down in 1882 a three-condition series for pathogenicity test of organism. Later on, fourth condition was appended to the Koch series by E.F. Smith in 1905. The cause postulates are as follows. The organism must be found associated with the disease in all the diseased plants examined. The second is the organism must be successfully isolated and grown in pure culture on the nutrient media. The third is the organism must be isolated from pure culture, must be inoculated on the healthy host, and must be the cause of the same disease on the inoculated healthy host. Now the fourth condition which was added, it was for obligate parasites. It is the isolated organism during the third step and grown in the pure culture again must be in the same character which is showed during the second step. The discovery of Bordeaux mixture. Now Bordeaux mixture is an important fungicide. and it was discovered by Professor P. M. A. Millardet of University of Bordeaux in France. This fungicide was discovered to prevent the downy mildew of grapes caused by Plasmophora viticola, which endangered the grape cultivation in Europe and threatened the wine industry in France. Millardet noticed that the farmers had protected the plants of grape vines by sprinkling verdigris. It is a mixture of copper sulfate and lime to discourage pilfering by school-going children. Now, this clue prompted Millardet that he finally concluded his work and published in 1885, disclosing that a mixture of copper sulfate, lime and water in the ratio of 5:5:50 is the Bordeaux mixture. Now, discovery of viruses. In 1880, Adolf Meyer began work on a serious tobacco disease which he named tobacco mosaic. He reproducing the disease by infecting the juice of infected tobacco plant into healthy ones. But he was not identifying the real agent that caused the disease. Similarly, Smith in 1981 demonstrated that peach yellow disease was also contagious. But he also could not determine the real cause. It was Ivanovsky Dmitry in 1892 who confirmed the Mayer's work. He passed the juice of diseased plant from a Chamberlain filter and found that it retained its infectivity. He thought that the causal agent of the bacterium tobacco mosaic is a bacterium. Bejarnik in 1898 tested the Ivanovsky's hypothesis and concluded that tobacco mosaic disease was not caused by bacterium or toxins secreted by it, but by Contagium vivum fluidum, that is living infectious fluid, which he referred to as virus and said that the virus multiplies on in vivo, that is in living beings. For this contribution, Bejarnik is honored as the father of virology. Now we come to certain histories, the history of mycology. In 1675, the Dutch worker Anton van Leeuwenhoek developed the first microscope. In 1729, Italian botanist P. A. Michel proposed that fungi come from spores. So he is given the name father of mycology. In 1755, the French botanist Tillet published a paper on bunt or stinking smut of disease and discovered bunt is a disease of the wheat. In 1807, the French scientist I. B. Prevost showed that bunt of wheat is a fungus and showed the evidence that the disease is caused by a microorganism. In 1821, E. M. Fries published Systema Mycologicum for naming a fungi. He was named as Linnaeus of Mycology. In 1821, Robertson of England stated that sulfur is effective against the peach mildew. In 1845, the Irish potato famine due to Phytophthora infestis caused starvation of million and emigration of 1.5 million people. In 1854, J.G. Kuhn published the first textbook in plant pathology, The Diseases of Cultivated Crops, Their Causes and Their Control. In 1861, Anton D. Berry, he is a Germany and worked on the life cycle of potato late blight and was the first to prove experimentally that Phytophthora infestans is the cause of potato late blight. He proved that fungi are the causes but not the result of the disease. So he is called the father of modern plant pathology. Anton D. Berry in 1865 reported the heterogeneous nature of wheat stem rust. In 1869, England loses a coffee production due to coffee rust and was forced to brew tea. 1881, H. M. Ward worked out the life cycle of coffee leaf rust and is called the father of tropical plant pathology. In 1882, Robert Hartig published a textbook Diseases of Trees and he is called as father of forest pathology. In 1885, P. Pierre Marie Alexis Mardet or PMA Mardet discovered the Bordeaux mixture. In 1818, E.J. Butler published a book on fungi and diseases in plants. He made an exhaustive study on the Indian fungi and the diseases caused by them. He is called as the father of modern plant pathology in India. He joined as the first director of Imperial Bureau of Mycology, that is Commonwealth Mycological Institute, CMI, now called as CAB International Mycological Institute, in Kew in England in 1920. He began the Journal Review of Applied Mycology with S.G. Jones and wrote Plant Pathology in 1949. In 1929, Sir Alexander Fleming isolated the antibiotic penicillin from the fungus Penicillium notatum. Then to bacteriology, the history of bacteriology. In 1683, Anton von Leeuwenhoek first observed bacteria. In 1876, Louis Pasteur and Robert Koch, they proved that anthrax disease of cattle is caused by specific bacteria. In 1876 only, Robert Koch of Germany described the theory called Koch's postulates. He established the principles of pure culture technique. In 1876 again, Robert Koch and Pasteur disproved the theory of spontaneous germination of disease and proposed the germ theory in relation to the disease of man and animals. In 1882, American plant pathologist T.J. Burrell first time proved that fire blight of apple and pear was caused by bacterium now known as Irvinia amylogora. In 1901 to 1920, E.F. Smith of USA gave the final proof of the fact that bacteria could be the incident of plant disease. He worked on the bacterial wilt of cucurbits and crown gall disease. He is also called as father of phytobacteriology. Chilton and his co-workers demonstrated that crown gall bacterium transforms plant cells to tumor cells by introducing into them a plant plasmid. In 1952, J. Lederberg coined the term plasmid. In 1952, S. A. Waksman won Nobel Prize for the discovery of streptomycin. In 1952 only, Zinder and J. Lederberg discovered transduction in bacteria. Now, history of virology. In 1886, Adolf Meyer described a disease of tobacco called mosaic cranehent, that is tobacco mosaic. Adolf Meyer demonstrated the cell transmission of tobacco mosaic virus disease. In 1892, Dmitry Ivanushky demonstrated that the causal organ agent of tobacco mosaic could pass through bacterial filter. In 1895, E.F. Smith of USA showed that the peach yellows was a contagious disease. In 1898, M.W. Bejarnik, a Dutch microbiologist and a founder of virology, proved that the virus inciting tobacco mosaic is not a microorganism. He believed it to be Contagium vivum fluidum, that is, infectious living fluid. He was the first to use the term virus, which is the Latin word for poison. In 1929, F.O. Holmes provided a tool by which the virus could be measured by showing that the amount of virus present in a plant sample preparation is proportional to the number of local regions produced on an appropriate host plant leaves rubbed with contaminated sap. In 1935, W.M. Stanley proved that viruses can be made as crystals, and he also got a Nobel Prize for this work in 1946. In 1936, F.C. Borden and N.W. Perry found that the crystalline nature of virus contains nucleic acid and proteins. In 1939, Koch and colleagues for the first time saw TMV virus particles with the help of electron microscope. In 1971, T.O. Diner discovered viroids, which only consist of nucleic acid. They are smaller than viruses and cause potato spindle tuber disease, that is 250 to 400 bases long of a single-stranded सर्कुलर मॉलिक्यूल ऑफ इन्फेक्शियस आरएनए. नाउ वी डिस्कस सम प्लांट पैथोलॉजिस्ट ऑफ इंडिया. ई जे बटलर 1901 to 1920, the first plant pathologist in India. He wrote a book, Fungi and Diseases in Plants. He is known as father of plant pathology in India. D.D. Cunningham and A. Barclay start study and identification of fungi. J.F. Dastoor in 1886 and 1971 was the first Indian plant pathologist. He worked on castor and potato disease caused by Phytophthora. B.B. Mundkar in 1948 worked on the development of disease-resistant varieties against wilt of cotton and identification and classification of Indian smut fungi. He established Indian Phytopathological Society in New Delhi. K.C. Mehta, he worked on rust disease in India. Then we have S.P. Ray Chaudhary, they worked on the viral plant diseases. Y.L. Naine reported Khera disease of rice. R.S. Singh wrote the famous book Plant Disease. So I hope you have gained a good amount of information through this lecture on plant pathology, history and development. Thank you so much.